guys, it's April. So today I am going to show you how to get this Elizabeth Harnois Hallie, my date with the president's daughter inspired look. It is a super easy eye makeup look that you can kind of do for like an everyday thing. It's just like a slightly smoked out eye that's very lifted. We have a nice shiny, somewhat frosted lip gloss, really rosy, glowy cheeks. The hair is just like lightly curled and the hair is like framing the face very nicely. I have my little butterfly necklace and this dress, which I will tell you where you can buy at the end of this video. But I love this movie. I remember when this movie premiered on the Disney Channel, and I remember the first time laying eyes on that pink like velour dress that she picks out. It's so beautiful. This girl on TikTok, by the way, found the actual dress from the films, and I'm so jealous of her. Not that it would fit me anyways, but you know. can you imagine finding that thrifty? I think she paid only like 15 bucks for it or something like that. Wild. But yeah, super easy hair and makeup, really cute, and a fun little nod to a really cool, nostalgic movie from my childhood. Yeah, enough of me talking, let's just get on to the tutorial. So the first thing you want to do is start off with some clean hair that's been brushed through. Do a nice little deep side part. Next, I am taking a hot, large curling iron with the clamp, and I am taking about 1 to 2 piece sections of my hair and just curling about halfway up the strand of hair, holding that for 20 seconds and then letting that go. It's gonna create a nice little like soft curl. And I am alternating directions so that my curls don't look super uniformed. We don't want like a crazy ringlet look, but you do want a slight curl, a little bit of body towards the end. And with the pieces of hair framing the face, I am taking my curling wand and just kind of bumping the ends inwards. And what that does is it's gonna allow those pieces of hair to just frame your face really nicely. And when you're done, you just kind of repeat that to the other side of the head. So once again, just take a 1 to 2 inch section, clamp it, roll it up, hold it for about 20 seconds, let it go, alternate directions. It's actually super easy. And this is honestly like my go-to hairstyle for like an everyday thing. Also, you could definitely put some heat protectant in your hair. I had that beforehand because I had to blow dry my hair. Anyways, I'm framing that last little piece, making sure that they're just kind of going inward so that they hug the perimeter of my face. And now I'm taking a little teasing comb and I'm picking up large pieces of my hair and just teasing and packing the undersides and kind of teasing the root of the hair framing my face so that it just kind of floats away from the face. And this is just going to add a little bit of volume and body to the hair. So if you have like really flat looking hair, this will be really helpful. And yeah, you just kind of like shake it out, primp and preen, and you're done with hair. Moving on to makeup, I am taking a small flat concealer brush and my foundation. And I'm loading my brush up with some of that foundation, and I'm gonna go ahead and carve out my eyebrows. And what this means is that you're just gonna trace really closely to your eyebrows and then blend out any product. And this is gonna give your eyebrow like a filled in look, but this is also really helpful if you're trying to create a somewhat thinner brow because you can get really close up to the brow. Also, you can fill in your eyebrows if you need to. I just kind of don't really do that anymore. Next, I'm taking my foundation and I'm dotting that all over my face, and with a dense flat stippling brush, I am just buffing that into my skin. I would like to say that I did moisturize beforehand, so please make sure to do that so you get a really nice finish. But I'm gonna keep the layer of foundation super thin on my face. I kind of just want to block out a lot of the redness, but I don't want like a full coverage look. I want to keep it pretty youthful and young. So just make sure you like buff that really well into the skin. You can use a beauty sponge to press the product in even more, but I just was lazy to wet my sponge, so I just used my brush.
Next, I'm taking a loose translucent face powder and I'm just like setting all the places that crease first. And then I am powdering my entire face down. I just really want to make sure that my makeup is nice and set. We're going to end up bringing a little bit of glow back into the skin later. Next, I am taking this little ColourPop palette, and with the fluffy blending brush, I'm picking up these like kind of medium toned neutral browns, and I am buffing that into my crease, making sure that that's being blended really well into the crease and then up towards the brow bone. And it's okay if you allow the color to get onto the eyelid, because you're going to take your finger later, and with that same brown shade, you're going to just pat that onto the eyelid and blend that there. And with that same brush we used earlier, I am taking a deeper neutral brown that's matte, and I'm just going to blend that into the outer part of my eye near the crease and then blending it up. It's just, I'm trying to create a very like uplifted look. And with a tiny little shader brush, I am picking up like a matte creamy bone colored eyeshadow and applying that to my brow bone and the inner part of my eye, and then touching that up with whatever product is left on my blending brush into the crease. And I'm adding a little bit more of that brown onto the lid. With that tiny little shader brush, I'm picking up a pearly sort of frosty eyeshadow and applying that just underneath my brow bone. And now I'm taking a little pencil brush and those browns we used earlier, and I am just working that into my bottom lash line for a little bit of definition. We want to smoke it out a little bit. I'm licking my brush because I'm gross, and I'm taking a tiny little angled brush and that matte deep brown eyeshadow, and I'm going to line my eyes with this. A black eyeliner would be way too harsh, but I do want a little bit more definition, so I am going in with a matte dark brown eyeshadow and just lining my top lash line. And then I'm going to wing it out towards the end, making sure that it's angling up towards my eyebrow. And using my brush and my finger, I am blending the wing like towards the crease. So you want to create that like little line. And then I'm also just lightly defining my bottom lash line. Next, I am taking that pearlescent eyeshadow again, and I'm just going to pop that into my inner corners to give me a really bright eyed look, just to kind of open up the eyes a little bit more. And next, I'm taking a white liquid eyeliner and I am just tracing just underneath the wing and then tapping that out with my finger. And this is going to give you a very lifted look. Apply some nude eyeliner to your waterline to make sure you look really bright-eyed. And I'm going to give my eyelashes a good curl because I want really upright eyelashes. I'm applying some mascara, really working that deep into the roots and then sweeping it up. I don't want to wear false eyelashes with this, so we're just going to stick with mascara, and whatever's left, I'm just going to brush through my bottom lashes. And with that angled brush we used earlier and that deep brown eyeshadow, I'm going to extend the inner corner of my eyes just for that like foxy feline upturned look. With a large powder brush and a coral matte blush, I'm applying this all over to the apples of my cheeks, sweeping that into my temples. I'm also going to go a little bit over my nose, my chin, my forehead, just to bring a little bit of life and color back into my face. It makes it look really youthful. And because I want a little bit of glow, I am taking like this pink orange highlighter and just dusting that onto the apples of my cheeks and a little bit on my nose, just so I can have a little bit of glow, but you could definitely just use like a shimmery blush instead. Next, this is completely optional, but I'm just taking a little matte neutral contour powder and this like really skinny angled brush, and I'm just gonna sweep this down the sides of my nose just to give it a little bit of definition. Once again, this is not really a necessary step, but I just felt like doing it today. Go ahead and apply a lip balm or a lip scrub to your lips. This is just gonna help assist us with removing any excess product on our lips because I'm too lazy to like be careful around my lips when I apply foundation. And I'm taking a little wipe and I'm just wiping off all the products, cleaning up my lips, following my natural lip shape. And now I am taking this like slightly frosty sheer coral lip gloss and applying that all over my lips for a little bit of shine and color. And that's pretty much it for makeup. I'm just gonna touch up my hair a little bit more because once again, it has fallen flat and I refuse to use hairspray. But yeah, that's basically it, guys. It's it.
And this is it for the completed look. The makeup is super easy. I chose to just kind of work out of one eyeshadow palette, just so that it shows you that you can use like any sort of basic neutral eyeshadow palette that you have. The eye is very lifted, but I think that's mostly due to Elizabeth Harnois, because she has these like really beautiful like upturned eyes that are so beautiful. I'm jealous. Really glowy rosy cheeks, a very like simple glossy lip, and the hair, I just kind of curled the ends very loosely and just sort of did a bit of a side part, let the layers kind of frame my face. I love that I'm blonde right now, because then I can like really get into this look. It's really exciting for me, you have no idea. I paired it with this little DIY butterfly necklace, which is literally just a butterfly hair clipped onto my like Playboy necklace. And this dress, which I bought at undergroundcostumes.com. I will be leaving a link down below to their shop, their Instagram, TikTok, whatever I can find. They specialize in recreating like really iconic pop culture looks. So they have like the Halle dress. They have like Katie Heron's like pink and black like racing stripe dress that she wore in Mean Girls. She's doing a Jennifer Check cheerleading outfit. I think she's gonna do like a Sharpay Evans tennis outfit. Like, she has a lot of really, really cute costumey but like wearable items in her shop, so I'm gonna go ahead and link that down below, because I know like if you're like me and you're watching this tutorial, you probably eyed this freaking dress since you were a kid. Like, I don't know about you, but I fantasize about this dress, and I'm so happy that I finally own it and I love it. I actually want to wear this for my birthday in a couple of weeks. In 1 week, I don't know when my birthday is. Anyways, doesn't matter. Yeah, super simple look. I feel very productive, you guys. I filmed 2 tutorials today. Can you guys believe it? I can't. I am in a new filming setup right now just because I had to rearrange some furniture in my room, but I kind of like it. I feel like more motivated to film, and the lighting and the setup is like a lot easier to deal with. So hopefully I will start filming more frequently. Fingers crossed, we'll see. But yeah, I don't know what else to say. I kind of want to wrap up this tutorial because I made my entire family like shut up for like 10 minutes. I was like, can you guys just like for 5 minutes so that I can film the intro and outro? I live in a full house with lots of people. It's really loud. But I've been going to sleep super early lately, so I know I can't film late at night. But anyways, you guys don't care probably. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. I will leave a list of all the products that I use down below in the description box, along with like social media handles and whatever else is usually down below. Thank you so much. You guys have been super sweet lately, and I love getting to read all of your comments and interacting and talking with you guys. And I love you guys. I love you guys. You're so nice. And you always make me feel really good when I come back. Oh, that's my dog barking, which means it's time for me to wrap up this tutorial. Thank you for watching, and until next time, bye.
Oh, Duncan.
Not more dresses. Oh.